Hello, everybody, and thank you for joining me today. It's Alan Barry Labuchan with the Rocks and Stocks News Show. Got an exciting guest. One of my favorite gold companies is i-80 Gold. In fact, I recently did my annual 2022 year in review, and i-80 Gold appeared in three separate sections. The Eureka Trend, because I'm so bullish on what's happening with a few companies in Eureka, led by i-80 Gold. Then they were also in the deep value section and also in the developer section of the mining machine, money-making machine section. You and I talked about you guys a lot just a few days ago. And thanks a lot for coming on to sort of do a year in review on i-80 Gold and maybe a outlook 2023.
Yeah, thanks for having me on again. And hope you had a great Christmas and Happy New Year. And really appreciate you continuing to support the company in your write-ups.
Well, it's sure been a great year for you guys, Ewan. Why don't we start with this report that went out from National Bank about your two-year performance relative to your peers?
Yeah, our company started about 20 months ago. So 21 was our first year. Amongst our peer group, we were one of the top performing stocks in our first year. The last year started a bit lower as we moved into a bit of development at Granite Creek, looked to becoming, a bit more people viewed as a development story. And then in the second half of the year, we made multiple significant discoveries at Ruby Hill that I think really catapulted our stock again into Don's note that was released this morning that his top performer, and I think we were the top performer in his coverage universe, and definitely at the top of the heap for our peer group, and really highlighted that there was for 2 years in a row. And we're pretty confident we're going to repeat again in 2023 because of what we're seeing in the advancement of our new discoveries at Ruby Hill. I think are hugely unrecognized by the market. But by the end of the year, I think the Hilltop Corridor is going to be a household name.
Well, you know, I remember us talking through the year, Ewan, and one of the things we talked about was having two world-class projects under one umbrella being developed well exploration, but then you added a third and two of them are on the same project.
Yeah, definitely. We've definitely had an interesting year. We started the year with Granite Creek as our flagship asset, the South Pacific Zone discovery. In my opinion, was phenomenal. The deepest hole is over 16 grams, over 15 meters. It's completely open. I think we have a world-class high-grade gold deposit there. We are developing it. We expect to be drilling that deposit from underground in the second half of this year. So that property was moving more towards the development. And in the second half of the year, we moved towards exploration at Ruby Hill. And because the property is so target rich, and right away we started hitting base metal mineralization. So adding a new component or diversification into our company, hitting these polymetallic zones that are rich in gold, silver, zinc, and lead, I think are really going to change the dynamic of how we grow our business in the future.
Well, you know, for me, it was kind of remarkable to think that Granite Creek could slide to your number two project, Ruby Hill becoming your number one. And the reason I say that is because Granite Creek has excellent continuity of the high grade. It's got a significant strike length. It's opened at depth and it's open to the north. And the same fault that is, you keep going and you run into a 25 million ounce gold deposit at Turquoise Ridge. And you guys are in the same kind of rock, same kind of geological structural story. And it's wide open as you keep going to the north.
Yeah, it is a remarkable deposit. I think it alone should justify kind of where we're trading as a company, because it is, as you said, right beside one of the largest mines in Nevada. And Turquoise Ridge is a 10 gram long-term, as you said, plus 25 million ounce mine. And we're right beside it, drilling in the same rock units, similar type of mineralization, and completely open at depth. But we expect that South Pacific Zone, we're going to be putting out a resource, initial resource for it this year. And we're expecting it to be that 10 gram or better range. So it's really a pretty remarkable deposit we drilled off. But then late in the year, we hit that upper hilltop zone at Ruby Hill, and it's right near surface. The average grade, the lowest grade interval on a dollar basis, is over $1,000 US per ton of our first five holes drilled into that discovery. So on a gold equivalent basis, it's twice the grade of the South Pacific zone. So I think that's why it's catapulted into number one, is because its grades are remarkable, and it's completely open for expansion in all directions. And we're just very excited about the prospect of it. And right beside it, we have a skarn deposit where we ended the year with nearly 40 meters of over 12% zinc in our first hole to test that target. So the scale or the size potential of this polymetallic base metal system we're drilling at Ruby Hill could dwarf our gold deposits. So it really has moved up in priority.
That's amazing to say that. And then right to the west, you've got the 426 zone that's right underneath the Archimedes pit that leads you to the Ruby Deeps. And you got some massively thick intersections at Ruby Deeps. And the other thing that's great about 426 is you unexpectedly got a significant amount of oxides.
Yeah. And that's going to be part of our economic work we're doing right now. We're expecting to release a preliminary economic assessment by mid-year for that project, focused entirely on the gold. So the Ruby Deeps and 426. And in that work, we are going to be establishing just how much oxide we have near surface. And if it's sufficient, we may look at just restarting the mill that's sitting right there on surface to process our oxide material, which would be a very low CapEx startup and bring us to production at that property on an accelerated basis. So Ruby Hill kind of has it all. It's got oxide gold, refractory gold, CRD or carbonate replacement mineralization, and skarn mineralization. And we have some very, very exciting geophysical targets to drill this year. And who knows, we might find a few more of these in 2023. And that will, I think, really open up the public perception as to what we're doing here.
Well, go ahead, Ian.
I was just gonna say one of the comments I really liked in Don DeMarco's note this morning was, you know, kind of our vision. If you look at Kirkland Lake, they developed in the Swan Zone, I think, what was the highest grade gold mine in the world at the time. And that vaulted Kirkland Lake from a $2 stock to, I think, 50 or 60 or 70. And it's rare that you find deposits of this caliber. And, you know, it's early days for this new discovery, but definitely we're seeing some good legs. We're drilling it right now. We're doing step out drilling. We're seeing a lot of mineralization. We really think we're onto something here, Adam.
Well, you know, I made the point that I think you guys are undervalued. I put you in my deep value plays, and I sort of calculated, I think you're around $60 an ounce for what's known resource. That's without the ability to grow your resources at Ruby Hill, Granite Creek, Ruby Deeps, 426, and the Hilltop CRD. So you're not getting much credit for any of those things just yet.
Yeah, we've got, I think, right now, the third largest gold endowment of any company in the United States. We expect to become number two with our new resource estimates that will be coming out in the first half of this year. The only company with a larger resource base than we do in the United States is Nevada Gold Mines. And of course, that's owned by the world's two largest gold producers, Barrick and Newmont. So it's a pretty enviable place to be. And the Hilltop discoveries and the Blackjack deposit aren't really factored into any of our resource yet, or aren't factored in. So when you put those into a gold equivalent, we expect we're going to be one of the largest holders of pure resources in the country.
Well, and that's, let's go back to Eureka before I got a couple more questions I got to ask you before we end. In Eureka, I'm just blown away by what I'm seeing from you, Paycor, and Golden Lake. You all have these CRDs with high grades of silver, zinc, lead, plus the overprint of the high-grade gold. That has to be a powerful mineralizing system that's pumping all of that fluid with the metals in it, and which brings me to the subject of the geophysics you talked about, that you could be looking at a deeper porphyry that's the heat engine for everything.
Yeah, definitely. If you look at the scale of the Carlin and CRD mineralization here, it goes for 10 kilometers. So it's a very large system, very high grades. You're right, what Paycor has been drilling is pretty exciting as well, just off our south boundary. And when you combine that, there is somewhere a massive heat engine. And if we could find that, you know, who knows, it'll probably be more copper mineralization. So maybe early next year, we'll be talking about copper in our interviews as well.
Well, even Little Golden Lake with their, you know, they hit like a maybe a 5 meter interval with 50 grams of silver, high grade zinc, or 50 grams of gold, high grade zinc, lead, silver. So, I mean, what's pumping that whole corridor that's like 6,000 meters from the Archimedes pit? You got a likely suspect there.
Yeah, it's got to be somewhere around there. Somewhere around there, there's going to be there's likely a porphyry, and that porphyry could be a pretty rich one. So we've got a nice target right by where our existing deposits are that we're planning to drill this year. But you know, we don't need to find a porphyry to be excited here. That would just be a bit of a cherry on the icing.
Well, when you look at that CRD with some of the values going from what, $1 to $5,000 per ton in situ value of metals in a rock, that's just off the charts.
Yeah, definitely. It is. It's pretty special what we're on to there. And we'll continue to release news from that probably starting in the next week or two. So we'll hear more for sure.
You're making Eureka the most important exploration camp in the world. Area definitely so. In Nevada.
I sure hope so.
Okay, before I let you go, Ewan, gold. I wanted to talk to you about gold. We've seen a nice, actually, your timing couldn't have been better to release that big hit of 10 meters of 60 grams of gold and the high-grade silver, lead, zinc, because right at the same time as you guys were starting to break out, gold was starting to break out. It's had a good start to the year. What's your feeling on gold, Ewan?
I think gold is it's been poised for quite a time, in my opinion, to break out. I'm predicting in 2023, we're going to see record gold prices. Things are starting to really shape up. We're seeing the U.S. dollar rolling over. You know, really, if you look at the U.S., the U.S. dollar was really strong, which pushed gold down. But the only reason the U.S. dollar was strong because it was considered the best of a bunch of bad currencies.
Because they were raising interest rates, which supports the dollar.
Yeah. But if you look at you own U.S. dollars, it's U.S. dollars is what is it backed by? How many trillions in debt is the U.S. today?
That's what it's backed by, debt.
Yeah. And the Canadian dollar is now 1.2 trillion in debt. The Canadian government, through their ideological policies, have essentially killed our country, you know, driven resource development out of the country. What else can Canada offer, really? I don't think you're going to see companies like Google and Microsoft move their head offices to Canada because everybody who works there is going to double their tax base. So, you know, we have to embrace what we have here in Canada, and they don't. So we're seeing our deficit that our company has double in the last 4 years. So Canadian US dollars are backed by debt. And if you look at gold as a currency that has no political attachment and has absolutely no debt obligation. So it's a unique currency. Some of the fire for gold is maybe taken away by the crypto as an alternate money. But after 4,000 cryptocurrencies being out there, it's hardly rare. And now we're seeing that we're seeing it tank a bit because investors, I think it was more of a momentum-based investment in the cryptos.
Absolutely.
And now that the momentum's gone, people are saying, well, maybe if governments start to regulate this industry, where do we go? And as I said, here's a currency that's been the first currency that people used in the world. It's one that you can hold in your hand. It can be used anywhere on the planet to generate money, to buy things or to trade for product. And as I said, it's got absolutely no political attachment, no debt obligation. You hold that gold, you can take it anywhere in the world and trade it.
Well, practically every currency in the world, if you had held gold, it would have helped you to fight inflation in your country. And now I think the same thing's happening with the US dollar, because they can't keep raising interest rates. They maybe have 0.75% left in them. Now the US dollar is starting to trade like a junior mining company when it hits bad news.
Yeah, and we're seeing the stocks in the US coming off with it because of the, you know, this all of a sudden the government's gone from saying, you know, this inflation is just a temporary thing to now it's here to stay. You know, the central banks in North America have zero clue. And as far as I'm concerned, they're reactionary rather than being ahead of the curve. And they're missing the boat. They're missing it right now. They're killing killing economies for their ideologies, really. And
absolutely.
And we're going to see a lot of pain. There's mortgages are going up.
Mortgages are going up and sales are dropping in real estate through the floor, like the most in recorded history of real estate. Sales are dropping. You got the whole real estate market and economy was built for 14 years on zero interest rates.
Yeah, definitely. There's a change in the air, and we're seeing that in the stock prices. We're seeing that with this inflation. Now we're seeing gold start to prop its head up like it should have, I think, 6 months ago. But it's not going to stop. I think we're going to see gold hit new highs, and the mining stocks are really going to profit. They will outperform the metal. So,
well, I think you've got one that's outperforming all your peers.
Yeah. And fortunately, yes. But 2023, I think, is shaping up to be a very special year for our industry, and hang on for the ride.
Well, and what you did in 2022 has set you up for an exceptional 2023.
I think so as well.
I'm going to close it off, you, and I know you're got to run out of the office here pretty quickly. If you got a second, you can listen in on the close. So there you go, folks. i80 Gold is performing better than its peers. The reason it's performing better than its peers is it's delivering with the truth machine in a big way. As Ewan said, they got Granite Creek, which looks like a really big deposit of high grade that goes towards a 25 million ounce gold deposit in the same kind of rock, same kind of structure. Over at Ruby Hills, they're delivering just phenomenal stuff at Ruby Deeps at the 426 zone. To the south, you've got the Hilltop CRD with the extreme high grade overprint of gold. And then right beside that to the east, you've got the Blackjack zone that altogether, I think this is one of the most undervalued gold stocks. I think they're on a path to phenomenal success. For investors that want to be exposed to a gold company without having too much downside risk, I couldn't recommend i80 more. And I got to thank you and Downey for being making it a point when he puts news releases out to come to our show and dig deep into those news releases so we can let everybody understand even more. Congratulations on a phenomenal year, Ewan.
Thanks, Alan, and look forward to talking to you in the near future.
Awesome. On that note, everybody, have a great day, and we'll talk to you soon.